Do you ever feel bloated, experience stomach cramps, or have unpredictable bowel movements? If so, you're not alone, and it could be irritable bowel syndrome. Irritable bowel syndrome affects millions of people worldwide, making everyday life frustrating and uncomfortable. But the good news? Understanding what's happening in your gut is the first step to feeling better. In this video, we're breaking down everything you need to know about irritable bowel syndrome, including what causes it, the most common symptoms, how the Bristol Stool Chart can reveal clues about your gut health, the different types of irritable bowel syndrome, and the best treatment options to help you take control of your digestion. So if you've been struggling with digestive issues and want real answers, stick around. This video is for you. Let's start by understanding exactly what irritable bowel syndrome is and why it happens. Irritable bowel syndrome is a chronic digestive disorder that primarily affects the large intestine. Unlike conditions such as Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, irritable bowel syndrome doesn't cause structural damage to the intestines. Instead, it's classified as a functional gastrointestinal disorder, meaning it affects how the gut works rather than causing physical harm. Irritable bowel syndrome is surprisingly common, affecting around 10 to 15% of people worldwide, with women being diagnosed nearly twice as often as men. The exact cause of irritable bowel syndrome isn't fully understood, but researchers believe it's linked to a combination of gut-brain communication issues, muscle contractions in the intestines, and heightened gut sensitivity. This means that for people with irritable bowel syndrome, the digestive system can overreact to certain foods, stress, or hormonal changes, leading to uncomfortable symptoms. Now that we know what irritable bowel syndrome is, let's talk about what actually triggers it. What causes irritable bowel syndrome, and why do some people develop it while others don't? Let's dive in. The exact cause of irritable bowel syndrome isn't fully understood, but researchers believe it's triggered by a combination of factors that affect how the gut functions. Unlike other digestive disorders, irritable bowel syndrome doesn't cause inflammation or physical damage to the intestines, but it does disrupt the way the gut and brain communicate, which plays a major role in symptoms. One possible cause is gut-brain communication issues. The digestive system has its own nervous system, often called the second brain, known as the enteric nervous system, ENS. In people with irritable bowel syndrome, the signals between the brain and the gut may be hypersensitive, making the intestines react too strongly to normal digestion, leading to cramping, bloating, and changes in bowel habits. Another factor is abnormal intestinal muscle contractions. Normally, the muscles in the intestines contract in a steady rhythm to move food through the digestive tract. But in irritable bowel syndrome, these contractions can be too strong, causing diarrhea and cramping, or too weak, leading to slow digestion and constipation. An imbalance in gut bacteria, known as small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, SIBO, has also been linked to irritable bowel syndrome. When there's an overgrowth of bacteria in the small intestine, it can cause excessive gas, bloating, and food intolerance, symptoms commonly associated with irritable bowel syndrome. Speaking of food intolerances, certain foods can trigger irritable bowel syndrome symptoms, especially gluten, dairy, artificial sweeteners, and high FODMAP foods. FODMAPs are short-chain carbohydrates that ferment in the gut, leading to bloating and discomfort in people with irritable bowel syndrome. Stress and anxiety are also key factors. The gut and brain are closely connected, and stress can worsen irritable bowel syndrome symptoms by increasing gut sensitivity and disrupting digestion. Many people with irritable bowel syndrome notice flare-ups during periods of anxiety or emotional distress. Finally, hormonal changes seem to play a role, especially in women. Research shows that irritable bowel syndrome symptoms are more common and severe during menstruation, pregnancy, or menopause, suggesting that fluctuations in estrogen and progesterone might influence gut function. While irritable bowel syndrome can be frustrating, understanding these triggers is the first step in managing symptoms. Now that we know what causes irritable bowel syndrome, let's dive into how it actually feels. What are the most common symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome, and how do they impact daily life? Let's take a look. Irritable bowel syndrome symptoms can vary from person to person, but one of the most common and frustrating signs is abdominal pain and cramping. This discomfort is usually felt in the lower abdomen and often improves after a bowel movement. The pain occurs because the gut muscles may contract too much or too little, leading to irregular digestion. Another hallmark symptom of irritable bowel syndrome is bloating and excessive gas. Many people with irritable bowel syndrome report feeling uncomfortably full, even after small meals. This happens because food isn't moving through the digestive tract as smoothly as it should, leading to the buildup of gas and a distended stomach. Irritable bowel syndrome also causes noticeable changes in stool consistency and frequency. Some people experience diarrhea, where bowel movements are frequent, loose, and urgent. Others deal with constipation, where stools are hard, dry, and difficult to pass. There's also mixed type, where individuals alternate between diarrhea and constipation, making digestion even more unpredictable. Another symptom that some people find concerning is the presence of mucus in the stool. While mucus itself isn't harmful, it can be a sign of excessive gut irritation, which is common in irritable bowel syndrome. Unlike conditions like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, irritable bowel syndrome doesn't cause blood in the stool, but mucus is a frequent occurrence. Beyond digestive issues, irritable bowel syndrome can also impact overall well-being. Many people with irritable bowel syndrome struggle with fatigue and sleep disturbances, likely due to the constant discomfort and gut inflammation disrupting rest. Poor sleep can, in turn, make irritable bowel syndrome symptoms worse, creating a frustrating cycle of digestive distress and exhaustion. The unpredictable nature of irritable bowel syndrome symptoms can make daily life challenging, but recognizing these signs is the first step toward finding relief. Next, let's take a closer look at the Bristol Stool Chart, a simple tool that can help you understand your digestion and identify patterns in your bowel movements. This chart categorizes stool into 7 different types, ranging from hard and lumpy to completely liquid. By using this chart, you can better identify patterns in your digestion and get clues about what type of irritable bowel syndrome you might be dealing with. Type 1 and 2, hard, lumpy stools that are difficult to pass. This is common in constipation-predominant irritable bowel syndrome, where the gut moves too slowly, absorbing too much water, and leaving stools dry and compacted. Type 3 and 4, smooth, soft stools that are easy to pass. This is considered normal and ideal for healthy digestion. Type 5, 6, and 7, loose, mushy, or completely liquid stools. These indicate diarrhea-predominant irritable bowel syndrome, irritable bowel syndrome D, where the gut moves food too quickly, preventing proper water absorption. For many people with irritable bowel syndrome, stool consistency doesn't always stay the same. Some experience mixed type, meaning they alternate between constipation and diarrhea. One day, they might have hard stools, and the next, they could have loose, urgent bowel movements. This unpredictable pattern can make irritable bowel syndrome even more challenging to manage. Tracking your stool using the Bristol Stool Chart can help you identify trends, understand how your diet or stress levels affect your digestion, and even provide useful information for doctors when discussing your symptoms. Now that we've covered how irritable bowel syndrome affects your digestion, let's dive into the different types of irritable bowel syndrome and what sets them apart. The first type is IBS-C, or constipation-predominant IBS. People with IBS-C often struggle with hard, lumpy stools, type 1 to 2 on the Bristol stool chart, infrequent bowel movements, and bloating. Stools can be difficult to pass, sometimes leading to discomfort and straining. This happens because the muscles in the intestine move too slowly, causing the colon to absorb too much water. On the other end of the spectrum is IBS-D, or diarrhea-predominant IBS. In this case, stools are loose, watery, and frequent, type 5-7 on the Bristol stool chart. Some people with IBS-D experience an urgent need to go to the bathroom, sometimes right after eating. The digestive system moves too quickly, preventing proper water absorption, leading to diarrhea, abdominal pain, and increased gas. Then there's IBS-M, or mixed-type IBS, where symptoms alternate between constipation and diarrhea. One day, a person might experience hard, dry stools, and the next, they could have loose, watery bowel movements. This unpredictability makes IBS-M particularly difficult to manage, as symptoms can fluctuate based on diet, stress, and other triggers. Finally, there's IBS-U, or unclassified IBS. This category is for individuals whose symptoms don't clearly fit into IBS-C, IBS-D, or IBS-M. They may experience general digestive discomfort, bloating, and irregular bowel movements without a consistent pattern. Identifying which type of IBS you have is a key step in finding the right treatment plan. Next, let's explore the best ways to manage IBS, including dietary changes, lifestyle adjustments, and medical treatments that can help relieve symptoms. Let's break down the best strategies to keep IBS under control. Dietary changes. One of the most effective dietary approaches for IBS is the low FODMAP diet. FODMAPs are fermentable short-chain carbohydrates found in foods like onions, garlic, dairy, wheat, and certain fruits. These foods can trigger bloating, gas, and diarrhea in people with IBS. By reducing high FODMAP foods and gradually reintroducing them, many people experience significant symptom relief. For those with IBS-C, constipation-predominant IBS, increasing soluble fiber, found in foods like oats, bananas, and sweet potatoes, can help soften stools and promote regularity. However, those with IBS-D, diarrhea-predominant IBS, should limit insoluble fiber found in bran, raw vegetables, and whole grains, since it can speed up digestion and worsen diarrhea. Hydration is also key. Drinking plenty of water aids digestion and prevents constipation, especially for those increasing fiber intake. At the same time, it's best to limit caffeine, alcohol, and artificial sweeteners, as they can irritate the gut and trigger IBS flare-ups. Lifestyle changes. Since the gut and brain are closely connected, stress management plays a big role in controlling IBS symptoms. Activities like meditation, deep breathing, and yoga can help reduce gut sensitivity and improve digestion. Regular exercise is also beneficial, as it stimulates intestinal contractions, helping to relieve both constipation and bloating. Adding gut-friendly probiotics to your diet may also improve symptoms by promoting a healthy balance of gut bacteria. Some people find relief from bloating and irregular bowel movements by taking probiotic supplements or eating fermented foods like yogurt, kefir, and sauerkraut. Medications and medical treatment. For those who need additional support, medications can help manage IBS symptoms. Antispasmodic drugs like hyoscine or peppermint oil capsules can relax intestinal muscles and relieve cramping. People with IBS-C may benefit from laxatives or stool softeners, while those with IBS-D might need antidiarrheal medications like loperamide, Imodium. In more severe cases, doctors may prescribe prescription medications that target gut motility, such as linaclotide for IBS-C or rifaximin for IBS-D. Some people also respond well to gut-directed psychological therapies, including cognitive behavioral therapy, CBT, and hypnotherapy, which help regulate the gut-brain connection and reduce symptom severity. While IBS can be challenging to manage, the right combination of diet, lifestyle changes, and medical support can make a huge difference. Now that we've covered treatment options, let's wrap up with some final tips on how to live well with IBS and improve your quality of life. IBS may be unpredictable, but with the right diet, lifestyle adjustments, and medical support, it can be managed effectively. We've covered the causes, symptoms, types, and treatments to help you understand and take control of your gut health. If you experience persistent digestive issues, tracking your symptoms and consulting a doctor or dietitian can be the first step toward finding relief. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more health content. Also, we'd love to hear from you. Drop a comment below and let us know. What IBS symptom do you struggle with the most? Let's keep the conversation going and support each other on this journey to better gut health.